it looks like we're like pretty much right on where I want to be.
All right, we're moving real quick, and there's something that I realized that I did not think about. So we headed downtown to near where we want to shoot the eclipse. So we're going to try and scope out the spot ahead of time. So the eclipse is going to happen in just a few days. And we want to just sort of see what the spot's like.
It smells
weird. Yeah. Man, Buckingham Fountain smells bad. So the shot that we're trying to do for the eclipse is actually right next to Buckingham Fountain. This is actually the first time we've actually ever seen it up close running. They had it off like pretty much all of last year. All right, so we're crossing the street here, and there's something that I realized that I did not think about in planning and that was not apparent on the map. And that is that there's a whole bunch of boats in the harbor. So this is gonna potentially make for some issues. We're kind of right at the spot, and it definitely doesn't look very good. Here we can actually see that the sun is gonna be right over near where the lighthouse is. And obviously looking at that, you can see that there's like basically just a ton of boats in the way. And unless by some miracle everybody is out sailing their sailboat at like 5 a.m., it's very likely that we're not gonna see any or have like a clear view of the eclipse. So I'm glad that we came out here today and not the day of the eclipse, because that would have wasted a bunch of time. What I'm probably gonna do is take another good look at photopills and kind of try and see if there's an alternative. I have a couple ideas. So I'll probably go over that, and we'll see what we can do instead of this location. Because having all those boats there is definitely not going to be very good for the shot. I just don't like it.
Okay, so are we heading back?
Yeah, let's go ahead and head back and take a look at the plan and try to figure out something else. Okay guys, now it's only one day until the eclipse, and I think I have an alternate plan that I like a lot better. After scouting and seeing that those boats were gonna definitely kind of obscure the lighthouse and kind of mess up what I had originally intended for the shot, I looked at some alternatives, and one of the things that I think we're gonna try and shoot instead is what's called the William E. Deaver water crib. The water cribs are basically these structures that pull water in from Lake Michigan for drinking water for the greater Chicago area. It's one of those things that I've always seen off the shore of Lake Michigan and always kind of wondered what they were. Figured that that would be a fairly decent subject for us to try and shoot. So the plan has changed just slightly. Since this new location is a little bit closer, it should be pretty easy for us to ride our bikes to it. So we're gonna do like a really early morning bike ride and hopefully be able to capture the eclipse. So now all we gotta do is wait. And so I'm gonna get my gear prepared now, kinda get everything set and make sure all my batteries are charged, the memory cards are formatted and ready to go, and see you bright and early in the morning.
fixing it. Okay, you're an optimist.
There's a bunch of geese out there. Best shot, I guess. We might have to move, like, randomly if for some reason our spot is, like, not exact. Yeah, I mean, it looks like we're, like, pretty much right on where I want to be, so let's take a look here. All right, it's coming. There it is. We're gonna get to see it. All right, eclipse is happening right now. The forecast said that it was gonna be completely cloudy, and it's not, and that's awesome. So I'm just so happy that we're able to shoot it here. It's super cool. Oh man, I think I'm gonna wanna move like that way a little bit, depending. I don't know, we'll see. So I'm just shooting right now on like a 5-bracket mode, 2 EV stops per bracket and 5 shots. And so that should hopefully give me some dynamic range to be able to get a lot of detail in the shot. Shooting at ISO 100 and F11, just F11 for sharpness. And I'm using just a little remote so that I'm not disturbing the camera while it's shooting. All right, we're moving real quick just for a different comp.
I think it'll be better.
Here, take that. Oh yeah, super cool. Check my focus. It's looking good. I'm gonna go a little bit underexposed since it's getting brighter now. And I'm gonna try a vertical comp just for the hell of it.
And move again.
No, I like it. Maybe aim down a little bit to get the reflection. There's a little duck in there. Let me double check my focus. Still looks good.
Yeah, the reflection's nice.
Yeah, super cool. Let me rotate it a little bit here. How cool is that? Oh, it looks so good. Epic.
Pretty good.
Well, I hope my settings were good. I think it was a success, even after a poorly scouted first location. in a newly scouted second location. I'm just glad that we got to see it, like...
Yeah, that it wasn't cloudy. It looked like it was going to be cloudy.
The forecast literally said it was going to be 100% cloudy this morning, and...
It still looks like it could have been cloudy.
Yeah, I think it's just, like...
It's haze.
The humidity is high enough for it to be super cloudy, but it happened to be, not. Weatherman got it wrong in Chicago. Who would have thunk?
Ready to go.
Anyway, thanks everybody for coming along on our eclipse adventure. Looking forward to being able to show you guys what we actually got. So that's going to be coming up next. All right, so we just got back and took a shower. So now it's time to download all our photos. I'm pretty excited to see what we got. Alright, just pulling everything into Lightroom. I want to make sure that I get everything, including all the thumbnails for the video. You can see I've got, like, everything is bracketed here, so there's just, like, tons of different brightnesses for everything. So my plan for these shots, since I shot bracketed, I've got 5 exposures per frame, basically. And those range from like really, really dark. Like I've got one here that is 1/1600th of a second. So that's like my ultra dark exposure. And then I've got one that's actually like 1/6th of a second. The 1/6th of a second might be a little bit too slow. So I can pick and choose which exposures I want to use, but I'm going to be using Lightroom's merge to HDR feature, which basically allows me to generate a 32-bit high dynamic range DNG file, and that'll give me a lot of leeway for doing edits on it. So I should be able to retain all the color in the sun, and then also get a bunch of detail in the water crib structure and in the foreground. So that's my plan for editing. So as I'm going through this right now, one of the things that's kind of cool, I guess, is that as the sun got significantly higher, it also got a lot brighter because it's being filtered through so much less atmosphere. And in that case, it's like, it's so bright that I needed my very darkest exposure bracket in order to keep detail in the sun. So if you look through this here, you can see that this is my very darkest exposure for this bracket. And it has like clearly defined like gradient colors, and it's not blown out in the sun, but everything else is like pretty much pitch black. And even if I just go to the very next exposure, which is 2 EV up, just 2 exposure values up, it's the sun is like completely blown out at that point, which is pretty telling of like how huge of a dynamic range I was working with later on during the sunrise. So I'm pretty excited that I was able to maintain and like keep that detail in the sun with my bracketing. I'm gonna go ahead and try merging this and just see what the actual merge looks like. It's looking pretty neat. I like that. We have a little duck in there. I think it'll be cool to kind of go through the rest of the shots and like try to see like what other, like if we have any other birds or stuff, you know, kind of flying in there or swimming across, just to make, you know, give it some variety. But this is like a really cool test shot. I really like it. You can see the 400 millimeter lens like really got some good detail on this water crib structure, so pretty happy about that. Looks like we nailed the focus really well. Alright, so this is looking pretty good. I'm pretty happy, but I got a lot of photos to go through, so I'm going to kind of go through and kind of cull. After I find my favorites, I'll pull those up and show you guys what I got. Thank you.
All right, thanks so much for coming along on our Eclipse adventure. If you want to see how we planned this shoot, I'll put a link to that in the description below. And if you're interested in the gear that we use, I'll have links to those as well. If you liked this video and you want to see more, please subscribe and check out all of our gear reviews, tutorials, and inspiration on lonelyspec.com. See ya!